Vibrancy Grants pretty simply is a way that we try to encourage people to think of new ideas to make the communities around the upstate more fun. It's all about people. And if you don't have places for people to come together and things to do, it's not as good as it can be. And we all want to be the best we can possibly be.
Our goal is always to enhance someone's experience in downtown, and creative projects is always one of the many ways that we can do that. So when we learned about the Community Vibrancy Grant that TATT at the Top through Phil Hughes was offering, we were excited about that opportunity. We've got several public art installations in downtown, and one that we're very proud of is the Carolina Wren. We also have a book published called Little Wren Lost. There's beautiful color illustrations and black and white illustrations, pencil drawings in those, so we chose to use those in this project. Two things that we did with the Community Vibrancy Grant funds is art boxes and crosswalk art. We did 9 of the art boxes and we did 6 of the crosswalks. The grant paid for 90% of it. You know, art projects don't always have to be expensive, and this certainly is an example of one that was not. You know, we're always in a hurry to get where we're going, but if we've got something, you know, interesting to look at, you know, maybe we'll pause for just a bit.
We just felt like the community was ready, there were enough good ideas, so we committed some money to do it, and with the great help of TATT at the Top, and applications came in.
I still remember last October when Ed called me and he says, "Suzette, I found this grant. It's called TATT at the Top. It's a vibrancy grant. It's what we've been talking about. Why don't we apply for it?" And I said, "That's a good idea, Ed." And he says, "Well, it's due tomorrow." Grant was 3 aspects of outdoor art. And you know, there are a lot of cities that will have, Anderson has fish and Greenville has their mice on Maine. So we thought it'd be kind of appropriate to have some cats representing Ram Cat Alley. So that was what the first thing we decided to do. And so the second one were the benches. And we're going to have those with an all aboard theme to bring into mind all the trains that are going through Seneca and how it's been, historically, it's been a very important train city. Third one is to do murals. It really beautifies the city. So we have one artist, and his name is Jim Juris, and his design says, "Welcome to Seneca." It's going to be downtown in Ram Cat Alley. We have a lot of talent in this area, many, many talented artists. So this one grant has done a lot for the Blue Ridge Arts Center. Now we have new board members who are getting on the board, and things are happening, so it's very positive.
In Seneca, we heard this story well after the fact, that they were about to sell their building, people weren't pitching in, helping. And by winning this grant, it just turned it all around. And we've heard stories of other people that didn't win, but because they were so focused on it and the word got out, they got other funding.
A couple of years ago, we were looking at different events that we could plan here in Greer. We host a variety of events from July 4th to Christmas to Easter. And we were looking for something that really showed off the cultural diversity in Greer. So we come up with the idea to apply for the grant and have an international festival that would just kind of bring everyone out from the Greer community and show off all the different cultures and countries that are represented in the economy here. And then we had the festival in March, because March is widely recognized as International Month. It was originally planned to be outside at Greer City Park, but as early spring or late winter weather would have its way, we had to move it inside of Greer City Hall. We were very fortunate to have a venue that we could just move an event from the outside to the inside on a day's notice, and it worked out great. Between 800 and 1,000 people attend. We had musical displays, craft displays, sports displays. We had a few food vendors there that had different cuisines from around the world. It was great. It's already on the books for this year. It will be April 11th. And now that we've done it once, that there's no turning back. We've had such a tremendous outpour of support from the community, and not just in the city of Greer, but in the greater Greer area and the upstate. People are contacting us throughout the year that's heard about it, that want to come and educate people about their country and their culture and the things that they have to offer also.
It's a just sort of the reality of life that action creates other actions. And it's good to see different things are happening in different areas, and to be able to make a difference is a good feeling for everybody.